welcome back to finals day at the Celcom Axiata Malaysia Open. Two finals completed, both won in two straight games in under 40 minutes. Our next final features two former champions, a repeat of the 2015 final, CHEN Long against LIN Dan. LIN Dan today in his fifth Malaysian Open final, but when we look at the race to Guangzhou, I can tell you that after this week in Kuala Lumpur, the number one and two on that list, the current world champion and the former world champion, will remain in the same positions. Shi Uchi, after his semi-final here, currently at four, he will go up to number three. But CHEN Long, if he wins today's final, he will be equal third with Shi Uchi. If he loses today's final, he will remain at number five. As far as LIN Dan is concerned, he's currently at 15. He's not even on that list. But I think he will come into the top 10 at number six after this week in Kuala Lumpur. Well, as far as the men's singles draw is concerned, there was three Chinese players at quarterfinal stage, and all three made it through to the semi-final stage. Two former winners started the whole week here, and both of them have come all the way through to today's final, because CHEN Long was winner in 2015 and LIN Dan was winner 2 years ago. So CHEN Long today in his third final here at the Malaysian Open. Winner, as I was saying, in 2015, and then a year later in 2016, lost in the final to Lee Chong Wei, making his ninth appearance at the Malaysian Open. And a huge roar for the left-handed LIN Dan, contesting his fifth Malaysian Open final today. Winner in 2017 when he beat Lee Chong Wei before other finals. 2005, can you believe that, so long ago, when he lost to Lee Chong Wei. He lost to Lee Chong Wei again in 2006. And in 2015, he lost to his opponent of today. Well, the immediate thing I'm noticing and a little concerned about is there seems to be a lot of strapping on the left leg of LIN Dan. The two-time former Olympic champion, five-time former world champion, Asian Games gold medalist. And this will be a 13th beating between these two players. Of the previous 12, LIN Dan has won eight of them. But CHEN Long has won the last two meetings. The last time they met was the quarter final of that Australian Super Series in Sydney 2 years ago. It was an hour and 18 minutes for 23-21 in the deciding game. Now that's interesting. One of the players has chosen ends, so they've swapped ends. I'm not surprised about that. Whenever there's a drift, I can't believe that a player wouldn't choose ends if they win the toss of the coin. Well, CHEN Long, after his semi-final yesterday against Jonathan Christie, was very animated, and that sends a huge signal that he is wanting to be back, the 30-year-old, after what by his standards was an indifferent year last year. Former world number one, 76 consecutive weeks as world number one, but now number five. Only match that went the full distance was the semi-final yesterday, but he'd beaten the former world number one, Kadambi Srikanth, in the quarter final, and in the second round beat the man who beat him last year, Wang Chulon of Thailand. So the semi-final yesterday opening game was extraordinary. CHEN Long was 9-7 up and then lost 12 in the next 13 points to go 10-19 down. Hence the three games in yesterday's semi-final. So to his opponent, the left-handed 35-year-old LIN Dan, also a former world number one. Currently 16 on the world ranking, and this is 14th appearance here at the Malaysia Open. Three of his matches have been the full distance, including the first round against the number three seed Chou Tien Chen of Chinese Taipei, the quarterfinal against Kanta Sunayama, and then in the semi-final yesterday against the number two seed, the World Championship silver medalist Shi Yuqi. That was an hour and 5 minutes. So considering the fact that he's been to three games on three occasions, perhaps the 35-year-old muscles are not as recovering as quickly as they used to, hence the strapping on his left leg. Well, it's the fourth all-Chinese men's singles final here at the Malaysian Open since 1983. Happened in 1988, 89, and of course when these two met in 2015. Well, he's very popular with the fans the world over, is LIN Dan.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, CHEN Long, China. And on my left, LIN Dan, China. CHEN Long to serve. Long
play. Well, certainly no doubt who the fans here in Kuala Lumpur are supporting, and that is the left-handed LIN Dan. Just wide. Well, he may be favourite with the fans, but Morden, when you consider that over the last 12 months he's had 15 first or second round losses, you have to really say that this man, CHEN Long, is the favourite for today's final.
Absolutely, great favourite to win. Of course, as you exactly mentioned, 15 first or second round losses in over the last 12 months. But you have to say congratulations to LIN Dan, well deserved, and an awesome display here at the Malaysian Open. However, you know, I personally think that LIN singles is possibly not in the best and healthy state. And if I was one of the men's singles players, I would probably have a sit down and have a long, hard think.
Yeah.
LIN Dan here creating a very, very good angle cross court.
So it's over. 1-2.
Just wide. Well, I was reading something earlier in the week that 12-time former champion here, Lee Chong-wei, was saying that if he couldn't play the tournament, which sadly he's not fit enough to play, he said if I wanted somebody else to win, it would be LIN Dan, my good friend LIN Dan. Of course, there's been so much publicity over the years about the rivalry between the two men, but off court, they're good friends.
They're very good friends. And, you know, when Chong-wei was saying it those many days ago, I don't think a lot of people gave that a chance that LIN Dan could actually win this tournament based on his past performance in, over the last 12 months. But here he is, and of course he's played really well in this tournament.
Yeah.
Three.
Left.
So it's all on 4-2. Jensen.
Oh, my
word. A good one.
Yeah. Terrific smash.
If Chen Long can keep playing with this kind of patience, strong defense, moving his opponent LIN Dan around as much as what he's doing now, waiting for this kind of opportunities, and then the ability to put it away in such a way, then he will win.
Yeah.
But whether he can keep it up is another matter.
Oh, that's another terrific smash.
Well, there's all the defensive work that Chen Long is doing that's really doing him a lot of good here. He's working LIN Dan well. He's really playing with proper length, good length on his shots, and waiting for the right opportunity. LIN Dan, in many ways, is controlling this rally, and Chen Long is just soaking up the punches, and then when the opportunity is there, that's when he goes for the big one.
Three.
Oh, he's ready to pounce.
That's when you can see that they know one another's game so well. Because, of course, this was a shot from Chen Long. This one, tempting LIN Dan to, OK, you go tight, I'll be there.
Yeah. towards the line.
Thank you. Service over, 4-7.
When he's at full stretch in there, struggling.
Please wipe the court. Thank you. Service over, 8-4. 27.
Terrific play, very, very good angle. The court will need to be mopped. And Dan just doesn't seem to have the pace at the moment to match Chen Long.
No, but the thing is that it's not the obvious thing that's making Chen Long playing well at the moment. It's his length of his shots is actually the key at the moment. He's playing with such a good length, which is ensuring that if Lin Dan wants to attack it, he is standing on that back line, and it's very hard for him to then rush forward and the follow up and try to make the kill and all that, because he's standing so far back on the court as and when he hits.
Yeah.
And that's actually the secret at the moment for Chen Long, is that he plays with such good length. Whether he can keep it up is another matter.
Service over. Time 10.
And a 6-point advantage at the mid-game interval for the reigning Olympic champion, Chen Long. So this is actually the third time this year that we've had two players from the same nation in the men's singles final World Tour event. Two Danes in Barcelona.
And Barcelona was one.
And then two Japanese players at the German Open.
Ah, that's true. Yes, yeah. That's true. many tournaments yet. We're on the ninth tournament of the year.
Yeah. There's only four same nation finals in the men's singles last year. Accuracy on that smash.
Thank you. So it's over 6-11.
I know the smash, the winner here from LIN Dan this time came long line, was down the line and all that. But it's interesting to watch that LIN Dan is playing more attacking cross-court shots in this match that he would normally do. Normally he's going very safe down the line, not having to scamper, as you say, the diagonal and all that. He just played pretty safe. But have a look at what he's doing today. So many more cross-court attacks.
Why?
I think he needs to do it. He knows that he needs to do it.
To shorten the rallies and go for the winner?
Simply early. Go for the winners, yeah.
Yeah.
36.
Tumbling net shot, or his opponent's tumbling net shot.
40-6.
Yeah, the whole rally was actually played in the forehand of both the players, mm-hmm. and then eventually CHEN Long goes to the backhand side of LIN Dan, and straight away the attack comes down the line, but he gets out of it with a beautiful cross. Mm. Very, very nice cross defensive shot.
Count of how many clears that was. And that's a beautiful cross court smash. Half smash, really, wasn't it?
Less on board.
Yeah. He was not going 100% on it, but still good power, I would say. A very, very accurate.
So it's all done.
Once again, just proving my point that, you know, he needs to play these cross courts and he needs to be very, very accurate on it.
Top of the tape before crawling over. Had a real think about it. This one from LIN Dan. Watch this. Oof.
First of all, ball, feet.
Well, he does have a habit sometimes of standing on the centre line when he's serving.
15, 8.
He certainly didn't move his, drag his foot.
You move your feet.
So he must have been standing on the line.
You move your feet before you give it up.
Oh, the umpire saying you moved your feet. We can't have been moving his feet. He must have been standing on the line.
Yeah. Yeah, he seemed to be standing very still when he was serving, delivering that serve.
Perfection. Half smash or fast drop, whichever way you like to describe it, but it's that cross-court angle you were talking about, once again having the desired effect.
Thank you. Service over, 9-16. So it's over. 17-9.
Quite frankly, at the moment, LIN Dan hasn't turned up to the party. Been outclassed at the moment. But he will have the better end in the second game.
Yeah, but if you look at it, both players have controlled the drift here really well. Haven't seen any of these unforced errors at all from both sides, where that got into the drift, that's out, and so on. Haven't seen one of those, so they control it really well. I'm not sure that's going to make a big difference whether they change ends or not.
Right, interesting.
But LIN Dan, on the other hand, have that knack. You know, he can turn matches around suddenly.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not going well here in the first game, but that doesn't mean he's down and out.
No. No, you never write him off. But it's game point opportunities now for CHEN Long, a whole host of them.
Game point, 9.
Opening game, 21-9 in 23 minutes.
Nine.
Yeah, no point here for LIN Dan to spend too much time and energy on it. Have to get into the interval between the two games here. Have to regroup, have to really see how is he going to come back into this match after having lost 21-9 in the first game in 23 minutes. But as we just said earlier, you should never ever write this man off. You don't know what he's capable of. Suddenly he's jumping out of the box and sometimes so unexpectedly. He still looks like a man with a purpose here in this final. So it will be very, very interesting to see how this second game will go. Second game. Chen Long to serve. But the first game he controlled beautifully.
Second game.
Not in trouble whatsoever. Let's see how it goes in the second game. Love all play. Called in by the line judge.
Chen Long
challenging straight away. He was definitely not in doubt. He was standing so close to it. The crowd is shouting in. They are definitely behind LIN Dan, and it's called in.
Challenge on top of two. One challenge remaining.
Chen Long not in doubt, but Hawkeye thought otherwise.
Another one finds the line.
Start indeed for LIN Dan here in the second game.
Well, you said it at the end of the first, but you never write him off. Never. He has this knack of coming back.
Yes.
There's a challenge here. I don't think he'll win that challenge. That looked white to me. Yeah, indeed it was.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. So it's over. 1-4 play.
usual sort of defensive shot we see from CHEN Long. Normally so good on his defence, but that one a little loose.
So it's over.
Longest rally so far.
Five.
Equals the longest rally. We had one at 34 shots in the opening game.
CHEN Long didn't put a foot wrong in the first game, and what a change it suddenly is here in the second.
Judgment there from CHEN Long.
Thank you. So it's over.
In badminton terms, that wasn't even particularly close.
No. He was hoping for the drift to take it, but CHEN Long did well to keep it in.
That's gone long.
So it's over. 3-8, Jensen.
Yeah, that one was out. Yeah. That was well judged.
That was so close. Takes courage.
Yeah, and again. Well, this is a good comeback.
6-4
straight points. Is definitely believable again.
Five.
That's where the good length comes in from CHEN Long. Look at that. Completely forcing LIN Dan to play a more neutral shot.
I suspect this might be the longest rally so far.
Again, look at that lift.
Yeah, superb, isn't it?
Yeah, what a great rally.
Yeah, that was perhaps the longest of the match.
7-8.
Good follow-up here by CHEN Long after pinning LIN Dan to the back line for a while. And correctly so, the longest rally, 59 shots.
To an end with those five straight points means that he is right back in his second game. I thought at 2-8 down, 1-7 down, 2-8 down. Things were beginning to run away from the reigning Olympic champion. Huge effort there from CHEN Long here to lunge forward so he could play the tight spinning net shot.
So it's over 8-9.
That's well judged. And he's back level.
9-0.
7 of the last 8 points.
Thank you.
He hasn't used many of those body smashes. That was a good variation.
So it's over 10-9. Play.
Game interval. LIN Dan with a 2-point advantage.
We saw LIN Dan at the interval between the two games. He definitely still looked a man with a purpose in this match, despite the fact that he's lost the first game 21-9. He didn't look like, oh, I've lost 21-9, what am I going to do? He really looked like he was, okay, I'm ready, let's go.
Yeah.
LIN Dan. 11, 9, play.
Certainly was.
Look, oh, he's scratching his head. Cannot understand it. How could I be so wrong?
But the other interesting thing was how short that clear was from being. It was on the double service line, wasn't it?
It was nowhere near
at the back of the court. By the line judge.
CHEN Long in that rally, pushing him from corner to corner.
So it's over. 13.
Peculiar around the heads shot there from LIN Dan.
I actually thought he would leave it.
Yeah, he didn't seem to have a backswing with it, really.
12, 13.
Over 14, 12. Well, in the opening game, CHEN Long was closing down the net area. There, he completely backed 15, off. 12.
I just somehow sense that I think we're treated to a third game.
Makes sense we might be.
Yeah.
13,
look how short 15. That lift was, Morton.
Yeah.
Because it's called good.
It's called good. And I think it's in.
Well, if he's wrong, he hasn't got any challenges left, CHEN Long. You're in a slightly better position than me to see. You saw that as in.
I saw that as in. Of course, it's coming very fast, but still.
Yeah, you were right.
No challenge remaining. Service over. 16-13.
Very accurate smash, look at that. Service just over. Inside the line.
14-16.
Yeah, extra pace.
I agree with 15, you, extra pace, and that's 16. What CHEN Long needs to do.
Yeah.
He's been playing too slow, and he's been giving too many options and too much initiative away to LIN Dan. He must start really pushing and putting more pressure and pace into it.
Going wide. So back level. 16 all.
Great lift.
Service over. 17-16.
Thank you. was waiting for the straight smash down his forehand side was LIN Dan.
Yeah, this one here, really waiting for it. Beautiful cross court though.
Yeah.
And a good follow up there by LIN Dan.
Deserved there, that block from CHEN Long. Look at that.
19-16.
2 points away from taking the second game now, LIN Dan. Inside the line. Wide by a whisker.
Service over. 17-20.
Yeah, it's not by much. CHEN Long in the third game, because I think a third game will be coming. This is too difficult for him.
Yeah, especially with the left one at that.
He must start to play faster.
Yeah. 21-17 confirms the umpire. Second game to LIN Dan. 52 minutes into the match, and it is one game apiece. These players looking for a first title in almost a year. CHEN Long's last title was
at
actually it was at the French, wasn't it? So it was only
October.
A few months ago.
Yeah.
There's LIN Dan, his last title was New Zealand Super 300,
which is a year ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, he beat Jonathan Christie in the final of that one. Two straight games.
Normally they have a coach to put that ice bag on the back of the neck.
Yeah, now they have to do it themselves. But it's interesting now when you're talking about coach, because both of these players, they're actually talking a lot to their coaches during the match, between points and so on. And I've noticed that LIN Dan is still kind of talking.
Yes.
It's like, okay, there's no one listening, but he's still talking.
Yeah.
Which is quite funny. CHEN Long is not doing it, but LIN Dan is talking a lot, at least to himself.
Exactly. And sometimes a gesture towards the coach's chairs, but there's no coach there.
Exactly. There's no one sitting there.
Of LIN Dan came back onto court, then he ran off court again, wiped his face again, now re-tying his shoelace. Could have done that in the 2 minute timeout.
Love on. Play.
It's
So third and deciding game. Well, of course, LIN Dan is not seeded in this tournament, Morton.
No, his ranking, he what? 14, 15?
16.
16, yeah.
Last unseeded men's singles winner here at the Malaysian Open.
Oh. James Chua.
Always landed well in. No.
That was around 2000.
The last one was a certain Mr. Lee Chong Wei. 2004
unseeded. That was close.
Yeah, that was the first of his 12 titles. That's what he was doing in the opening game.
Yes, that's what we talked about.
That yeah.
He suddenly backed off from the net, as you said.
Yeah.
And now he's staying there.
3-2.
Lee Chong Wei watching this final. 14 finals he contested here, winning the title a record 12 times. Missed it. Yeah, that didn't look terribly good as he landed there, Morton.
No, he did not. But he seems to be okay.
Service over. 3-3.
That may have been just wide, but there's no call or challenge from CHEN Long.
4-3. CHEN
Oh no, it was plumb on the line.
Yeah.
Plumb on the line. What a great shot. Thank you.
fantastic. Well, CHEN Long, at times, Morton, looks to me as if he's lost his patience. And the one thing I think about CHEN Long is what a patient player he is.
Yeah, you're right. It's a contradiction here.
Yeah.
And I think the whole plot about trying to tire out LIN Dan is gone out the window. Mm. That should have been, you know, going on from the first or second game, starting to do that here in the third game. That would be too late. LIN Dan would not tire out in the way that CHEN Long would like him to do.
Missed another. Well, the match clock ticks over the hour mark. And we're still in the early stages of this deciding game.
Six, three. Yeah.
That's very unlike CHEN Long. Tactical awareness there from CHEN Long.
Service over. Four.
He's hitting the shuttle straight at his opponent.
Defensive shot first.
Yeah, amazing.
Getting it over CHEN Long as he's coming in. This one there. Well, of course, what a finish.
Yeah, you don't get tighter than that on the next shot. Look at that. Magnificent.
So it's over. 7-4.
Signs to me that he's losing his patience. Longest rally of this deciding game so far, I think.
8-4. CHEN Long. You must really dance it quickly, okay?
Now, what was all that about?
Play.
Umpire feels that Chen Long is taking too long time to receive. Getting ready.
The match. Yeah, definitely long. And so is that, and it's a 7-point advantage for LIN Dan. The change of ends here in this deciding game. Decision to leave it from LIN Dan. Well, you said it, Morton, in the opening game. You said that he finds a way to come back, LIN Dan. I mean, he was outclassed in that opening game.
Chen Long played really well in the first game, and LIN Dan not really able to follow pace. But after that, it completely changed around. And LIN Dan, he's played solidly, but I also think it's a lot due to the fact that Chen Long can't get his game together.
LIN Dan. Again, stop. Chen Long.
There's one of his gestures where he was pointing to the back, and there you are, coach. I should have left that one.
Yes. Can you guide me? Was it in or out? Just saw the end of that.
Yeah.
That's out.
6-11.
Good smash from LIN Dan, but it's normally these defensive shots from Chen Long where even though he's at full stretch, he seems to get it back and get it back with interest. But he hasn't been able to find that touch today.
No, he's normally really good getting these counter-attacking opportunities out of what we just saw here, but today it's not worked.
Seven,
I think the string's
gone.
Yeah,
I think so too.
Yeah. 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 No wonder he couldn't control it.
Quick one. LIN Dan.
Yeah, there's sticklers for tidiness of the kit bags.
Serve is over. 13-7. Can you settle?
I think we're on our way to a surprise here. I think that LIN Dan, of course, 13-7 up, but he's looking like the better one of the two players at the moment.
Yeah, I concur.
And who would have guessed that when the tournament started?
Absolutely. Well, not me, for one.
14-7.
Seems inevitable now, with a 10-point advantage, that LIN Dan will win his second Malaysian Open title.
It will be interesting to see the ranking coming out on Tuesday, how high LIN Dan goes in that world ranking after a win here.
Too late, one suspects.
Yeah, there was great hesitation here from LIN Dan, of course, setting up an opportunity. As soon as you see the shuttle is kind of dropping on the back line, then you start moving forward and forward, because you know not a lot of good things can come from a situation like that.
Service over. 8-18.
Thank you. one left.
Nine, 18.
Missed it. 2 points away from his second title. LIN Dan, 2 years after his first here at the Malaysian Open.
So it's over. 19-10.
Yeah, good call, line judge. Fist aloft, he hasn't won yet.
It comes very soon though.
I think so too.
Point.
But not the first
seven
time.
11-20.
Done it. 21-11 in the deciding game. An hour and 17 minutes. And he looked as if he was a little emotional at the end there, sinking down on his haunches.
Match won by LIN Dan.
Well, that is a remarkable comeback. Some lucky fan is going to get one of his rackets.
Going to get a broken racket. As they're all jumping on it.
Yeah, he's absolutely delighted, that fan. And so is LIN Dan. Adds to the trophy cabinet. A little wave. And a second World Tour title. But this, two tiers higher than his previous one. Well, having been outclassed in the opening game, LIN Dan coming back strongly. Yeah. The emotion. And the first player since Lee Chong Wei in 2004 to win the men's singles title here when unseeded. Their confirmation of the scoreline, 9-21, 21-17, 21-11. In the deciding game. Well, he waits for the prize presentation. hugely popular all over the world. Ladies, LIN Dan. And you have to feel a little bit sorry for CHEN Long because he's such a gentleman on court. Always plays with great sportsmanship. And yet the fans don't love him in the same way as they love LIN Dan. I suppose the charisma of the two-time former Olympic champion. So they wait for the presentation party, which includes Lee Chong Wei. Third final here for a second time, settles for second best. That's a lovely moment.
And champion, LIN Dan China!
LIN Dan's second Malaysian Open title, 2 years after his first. Medals and the check. Invited onto the top of the podium by both finalists. Sadly unable to play this year, Lee Chong Wei. Still not fully fit after his cancer treatment. Well, after the excitement of the men's singles, we will have the women's singles coming up in a moment, and it's the defending champion in her fourth consecutive final here, Tai Su Ying, up against Akane Yamaguchi, who's making history as the first player from Japan to contest the women's singles final here at the Malaysian Open.